Zach, I appreciate it.
No problem.
Very rarely do I get to do this in person, but you're from Wisconsin.
Yeah, it's always nice to be able to have these conversations with you guys in person and also within the same state. It's always fun too.
Absolutely. So tell us who you are and where we're at.
Yep. I'm Zach Goldie, the president of Kitchen Solvers.
Awesome.
And so I've been here about 7 years. And this year has been a lot of fun for us. We've made it through COVID and a lot of that stuff that happened through this last year and a half.
Right.
And we're doing well. It's been a lot of fun this year.
How many franchisees do you have now?
We're at 48. And so we're kind of see ourselves as more of a re-emerging brand. We're a 38-year-old company.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're starting to kind of really hone into this new business builder type of mindset and starting to capitalize on that.
That's awesome. This is kind of a family thing because let's face it, you don't look old enough to have a 38-year-old brand.
No. New ownership took over in 2010.
Okay.
And so I joined the company about 7 years ago.
Okay.
So one of the partners in the business is my father, which I kind of was able to get into the business. Working more on the operational side of things, I came into the business with more of a manufacturing background. So processes, how do we do things more efficiently?
Okay.
And so I brought that to Kitchen Solvers, and the rest is kind of history at that point.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
You guys are doing great. I mean, you're validating well, your
mm-hmm.
owners seem happy,
right.
which is the most important thing, right?
Yep.
So talk a little bit about what you're looking for in an owner. I mean, a lot of people, when I start talking to them, say, I have absolutely no idea how to remodel a kitchen. I can't look at that. And one of the things I have to try to convince them is like, that's what the franchise is for. So that's why you're doing this. But talk about more what you're looking at when you're looking for someone to be like your perfect owner.
For sure. Kitchen Solvers is really built off of the backs of kind of those woodworkers or those people that wanted to get their hands dirty. And in 2010, when new ownership took over, we decided that we needed to change the business model to make sure that we're building something that they have to sell at some point or passed on to the kids or whatever they want to do with the business.
Okay.
And so we're going after people that have that business mindset and want to scale the business using people. And so we're looking for managers, people that can communicate well. I would say that the majority of the owners that we have been bringing into Kitchen Solvers don't have any background in kitchen modeling whatsoever.
Right.
And but there is one common theme is that they all understand that the kitchen is a very important room in the home.
Okay.
It's where families are gathering, and they all can take pride in that space that, frankly, has become probably one of the most important spaces in the entire home as of recently, too.
Right.
So,
absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. So how about, how do I want to word this? So I know we have to be careful when we talk about item 19 and that type of thing, but owners are happy, they're making money. How long does it usually take for someone to get in the business and then start scaling to, you know, how long does it take for someone to become from a rookie to, okay, I think I got this.
Right. So a lot of that is actually very dependent on the franchise owner. So when they come into the business and when we can time their training, as soon as they're done with their training, they're open for business. We launched
awesome.
Our websites very, very quickly, probably within a couple of days of signing the agreements. And we want to start building that SEO value.
Okay.
And with our new marketing platform and the industry, we're generating these almost within probably 2 or 3 days. And I have countless stories just this year of people really ramping up very quickly, kind of really catered to their style and how they want to do it.
Okay.
And then it's up to the franchise and how good that sales process is and how much they adhere to our standard operating procedures to make sure that they get that first sale signed very quickly.
Okay, that's awesome. So in this model, ever putting on a cabinet door if I'm an owner. I'm not necessarily pounding the nail and doing that type of thing. So what does my life look like as an owner?
Well, so you don't have to. I do have a few owners that still want to get their hands dirty every so often, just to kind of say that they've done it and that they can now manage installers.
Yep.
But what we're doing is we're establishing a lot of good relationships with our subcontractors, and we're also going out there to try to find employees.
Okay.
So a lot of our owners also take on more of that sales mind when they come in, and they want to be the first face that the customer sees.
Okay.
And so a lot of them are running sales appointments, and they are doing that for a little bit of time until they start scaling back a little bit.
Okay.
There's no way to grow this business to what they want to unless you start removing yourself from the day-to-day activities and start managing those employees and making sure that that they're doing the right things to make happy customers at the end of the day.
That's awesome. So what does Kitchen Solvers look like in 1 year and then 5 years for you?
Right. You know, part of our core values is innovation.
Yep.
We have a lot of cool technology that is coming through the pipeline right now. We're just launching with all of our new franchises. So streamlining the entire customer process, making sure that we're there on time through our dispatching software, being able to invoice and secure payments very quickly through our customers. So all that technology is coming down the pipeline. But we also want to start growing our geographical footprint.
Okay.
We're at that point now where we understand that the business model is there. The industry is really hot right now, and has also proven itself to be very steady through not only just a recession, but also a pandemic now.
Right.
And so we can take that and start running with it. And so we'll start growing our geographical footprint through our existing owners or new owners.
Okay. Well, I'm here to help.
Perfect.
Okay.
We're excited about that.
Thanks.